Yeah, students. Yesterday, what I show you, let us take rapid revision of that. We learn how vernier works. We see the construction of vernier calipers. We also see the history of vernier calipers. Vernier calipers is found. Pierre Vernier discovered this vernier calipers. Calipers means measuring device, and vernier is for French mathematician. So, and construction, let us see the construction first. Here, main scale. In main scale, lower numbers are centimeter, upper numbers are inches. But in practical lab, we are going to use this centimeter scale only. Then this movable scale is called vernier scale. Then you can see two pair of jaws, A, B and C, D. A, B are fixed jaws and C, D are movable jaws. Then you can see that these jaws are in vertical, their edge are in same line, straight line. That way, this side also. Why it is, if we join them, then you can see that they can merge to each other. Here, also we discuss about zero error. Zero error, that is, in this vernier calipers, we can see this, that zero of vernier scale and main scale zero are coincide on each other. But sometimes it is not. And when vernier zero is right side to main scale, then we are called, well, we can say that here positive error is there. And whenever positive error is there, then we will subtract the number. What number? That we will see that which one division of vernier is coinciding on main scale. And that number, suppose one example was there for 3. Third number division is coinciding, then 3 into 0.01, that is least count of vernier calipers, and 0.03. This is the positive error, 0, vernier scale 0, is left hand side to this 0 of main scale. Then that is negative error. And when again we will find out which one vernier's division coincide on main scale, and I have given you one example of 5th number division. If 5th number division, then 5 into 0.01 least count, we will multiply with least count, then 0.05. what we will do, this error is negative error, so we will add 0.05 at the end of the observation. So this are zero error of vernier calipers. And also we learn that least count of vernier calipers. Least count of vernier calipers, we find this way. 1 MSD. MSD means main scale division. Main scale division, 1 main scale division measures 0.1 centimeter, or we can say 1 millimeter. Here I am writing in centimeter, so 0.1 centimeter divided by n. N means vernier scales, number of vernier scales division, and that are 10 for my vernier calipers. Sometimes it is of 50 also. When you will learn about traveling microscope, at that time you will learn that also. But here 0.1 divided by 10 centimeter is equal to 0.01 centimeter. Type of error, here no type, no zero error is there. So I put dash here. The number of division of vernier scale which coincide with zero mark of main scale, that is small n. If error is there, then we need to find this number. But here no error is there, so I write dash here. And also, if I have this, then according to the error, if positive or negative, then I will do that calculation. Here, we are going to see the part two of this vernier calipers practical. Measure the dimension of a given regular body of known mass and hence to determine its density. Mostly they are asking for density. So we are going to do this practical, and for that mass also is given. Here observation table is there. But before this practical, let us revise yesterday's practical, that was hollow cylinder and bob. We find out the inner and outer diameter of hollow cylinder and the diameter of bob also. So let us see first. Here for hollow cylinders, outer diameter, what we will do, we'll fix it between the lower jaws. Here these two jaws are called lower jaws. So I will fix this at the lower jaws. Your question is there that how we can take first reading I have taken, but how I can take another two readings. So for that, I can move this little bit lower side, and then I will take a second reading. Again, you can move this upside and then take reading. Mostly here, you can see that the main scale reading mostly remains same, but the coinciding vernier scale division, you will get differently. We'll use upper jaws of this hollow cylinder this way, and then we will find out. Now, first, if I take first reading this way, for another reading, what I will do? I will move this. First, I kept this way. Now, I will put this cylinder this way, upper side. Then little bit different reading you will get. This way you will write down three readings of this hollow cylinder. Then for this type of sphere, which we can call bob. So for that, you will use lower jaws. And this way you will take first reading. Then you need two more readings. At that time, what you will do, you move this sphere this way, any you move it at 90 degree or 180 degree, and then again you will take the reading. We can complete our practical. Now let us see our today's practical, that regular body. Here I am having one regular block. You may have this in practical lab. They may give you a wooden block also, but here I am having this slab. So what we need to do here, we need its density, and for density we need its volume, and for volume we know for the cuboid, volume is equal to L into B into H. That means we need length, breadth and depth or height of this block, then only we can find out volume. So how we will find out its length? First, let us see this way. Here you will use lower jaws. This edge is its length, this edge is its breadth, and this edge is height or depth. So let us find out first length. If you observe in your observation table, you will find this length, breadth, and height. So you need 3 observation for length, breadth, and height. So let us see fast. First, I take length, take observations for length. This way, I put this slab here. Then I will see the main scale reading. Main scale reading is 7.6. And then I will find out the coinciding number, division number of vernier scale. And that that you can, it may that you are able to see here. So here you can see that 7.6 approximately, not approximately, but 7.6 is the main scale reading, and second number division of vernier scale is coinciding on main scale. So this way you need to observe this. Then you will write down main scale reading 7.6, then coinciding, number of coinciding division 6, then you will multiply with least count, then you will get 0.06, and when you add 7.6 plus 0.06, you will get the reading 7.66. That way I have taken this another observations also. How I take this different type of observation? For that, I move this. First, I take here observation, then I take here observation. Then also, you can do that. You move this this way, and then also you can take observation. Then different type of observation you will get. Now for breadth, I will put it, the block I will put like this, and you can see the observation here. 5 is the main scale reading. 5 is the main scale reading. Then I will search for the coinciding number of division of vernier. Sometimes it is happening that 5th number of vernier scale and 6th number of vernier division is also coinciding. Then at that time, you need to take 5 number. So always take smaller number of coinciding division. So that way I find here 5 main scale reading and number of division 0.04. And if I multiply with least count, then I am getting 0.04. And on adding this to 5 plus 0.04, 5.04, this reading is for this breadth. So this way, I take 3 readings, and by these 3 readings and by taking its mean, I will get breadth of this block. Now for depth or height. Now you easily understand that this block here, and then I will see the observations. And here I am getting 1.1 on main scale. 1.1 on main scale. Here you can see that the vernier scale 0 is between 1.1 and 1.2. But I will take main scale reading as 1.1. So 1.1 I have taken here. Then I search for the number of division of vernier scale which is coinciding on this, that I am getting 8 number. Here 8 number division is coinciding on main scale's 1 division. So here I take this way 1.1 all 3 times. I am getting main scale reading as 1.1, and this number, you can see this repeating number also. Sometimes you are not getting different reading. At that time, 2 readings you can write down same. So I got it same. So I write here also the same readings. So 1.18 and 1.17 and 1.17 is reading. Now let us go for calculation. Here, first I take these three, L1, L2 and L3. Here I take L1 plus L2 plus L3 is equal to, I take its mean, and by getting mean, I am getting 7.64 centimeter. Here, you need to write, at the end, you need to write the unit of kilogram per meter cube. So here, if you want or if you need 7.64 raised to minus 2 meter. So here only you can convert this into meter for breath. You can see I take that three reading of breath and I take mean of this and I am getting 5.04 centimeter. Here also, if needed, you can write 0.5.04 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Same way for height also, I take this mean value, and here also you can write 1.17 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Now volume, as we discuss, for volume we will use this formula LBH. So I multiply length, breadth and height, and I am getting this 45.05 centimeter cube. If I want to convert it into meter cube, then what it will become? 45.05 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube. As you know, here density, this is our volume. Now, with the help of volume, we are going to calculate density of the material. Density, for density rho is equal to m upon v. M is weight of this block. That is 130 gram divided by this volume, v. So, gram per centimeter cube. By calculating, I am getting 2.88 gram per centimeter cube. But if here you can see that in result, I have to write this in kilogram per meter cube. So I convert it into kilogram per meter cube. For that, what I do here? 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 10 to the power minus 6. Why? Gram to kilogram, 10 to the power minus 3. And centimeter cube to meter cube is 10 to the power minus 6. And so I am getting 2.88 into 10 to the power 3 kilogram per meter cube. So at the end, don't forget to write down the result. And in exam, please read the question properly. They are writing in question that find out the density in kilogram per meter cube. It may be the question is like that. Then find out the density in gram per centimeter cube. So at that time, be careful about result. So if they ask for gram per centimeter cube, then write down this result. And if they ask for kilogram per meter cube, then write down this answer. Now, the third part of this practical, measure the internal diameter and depth of a given cylindrical object like beaker, glass, and calorimeter, and hence to calculate its volume. Here I am having one beaker, and with the help of vernier calipers, I need to find its internal diameter and depth. Because you know, volume for cylinder is equal to pi r square h. But here we are finding d. So I will use directly pi d square h by 4. So for that diameter and depth, internal diameter, to find its internal diameter, discuss first. Whenever we are going to measure inner diameter, we'll use upper jaws of this vernier calipers. So what I will do, I will put it this way, and then I will see the observation. Here you can see that 4.7 is there. And then if I see for the coinciding of vernier calipers, then I can see that nine number division of vernier calipers is coinciding on this. So this reading 4.7 is main scale reading, and nine number of division of vernier calipers is coinciding, then 0.09, because we are multiplying with least count. So the final reading is M plus V 4.79 centimeter. Same way, now two more observation. First I take this way. So this time I will move it to 90 degree or 180 degree, and then I will this way inner part diameter. For inner part diameter, I have taken three observations, and then by taking its mean value, I got the diameter of inner diameter of this beaker 4.68 centimeter. Now depth, here you need to see properly. We see vernier scales lower jaws use, upper jaws use. Now we are going to see the use of this metallic strip that is called tail also. So here, for measuring its depth, what I will do, I will put it this way, and here this end of tail is touching to the bottom of this beaker, and this end is touching to this upper part, its edge, and then I will take the readings. Here you can see that 7.0 is its main scale reading, and then I will search for the coinciding division of vernier scale, and that I am getting 8 number. So this one reading I show you, 7 and 8 number of division is coinciding, and 0.08, then the final reading is 7.08 centimeter. This first reading I take this way. Now what I will do, I will take another side of this, then another side of this, and this way I will take different observation, and here you can see there these different observations. Now what I will do, I will do that, calculate the mean of this depth H1, H2, H3. Here I have done for you. So I'm getting 7.17 centimeter its height or depth. As we discussed the equation of volume, V is equal to pi d square h upon 4. You may use pi r square h also. For that, if you want to use that formula, you need to divide diameter by 2. And first of all, calculate for radius r, and then you will use that formula. Calculate. But here, I have calculated directly with the help of this formula. pi, always take 3.14. Multiply by d, d square. So 4.68 into 4.68 into 7.17 divided by 4. And on calculating this, I'm getting this answer, centimeter cube. And if they ask, here you can see this, in this result, we need to write the answer in meter cube. So I convert it into meter cube. Because multiply with 10 to the power minus 6, I move this decimal point to this and write it in standard form. So 1.2328 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter cube. So here, approximately, we can write here the result. Internal volume of given beaker is 1.23 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter cube.